using NTPB. And that is why it becomes a lot easier. The subsidy we carry throughout KTDA, we have to find it through NCPB. So sometimes when we give money to NCPB, they pay ile wako naye kwanza. So KTDA inabaki nyuma. Lakini vile mmenieleza, because I wanted to know, and I'm going to look at the numbers. I'm very keen on numbers. So mtu asifikiri hapa ati kuna numbers itapotea. Hakuna numbers itapotea. So nimeuliza kwa sababu nimepata brief na taarifa ya shilingi bilioni tatu na shilingi bilioni mbili. Kabla sija authorize hiyo pesa, nataka nipatiwe, I've asked for some details because I know how much we paid. And I want to know how much farmers paid so that I can pay the difference. Sindio? Yes. Kwa sababu, mimi sina pesa. Pesa ile mimi niko nae ni taxes ya wananchi. Na siwezi kupatiana pesa ya wananchi kiholela. I must be sure that we are paying for subsidy on account of what farmers paid and how many farmers paid. I hope the management of KTDA is listening to me very carefully. And just to give you a heads up, I have the figures. So, mwende mujipange mkijua, I know what I'm saying. Yeah? Otherwise, mwezi huu wa sita, we will organize the first tranche of the money on the subsidy program. Alafu, tukimaliza budget, our waheshimiwa, waki-approve budget, we will pay the difference. That way, we can account for public resources, but we can also support KTDA to support farmers. Jambo la pili, nilisha uliza wale wananisaidia kusimamia sekta hiyo. Tulikubaliana ya kwamba management services ya KTDA kuwe na management agreements. Pale mbeleni ilikuwa 2.5%. Tumesema ili pesa nyingi ifike kwa wakulima, tupunguze management services kutoka 2.5 mpaka 1.5. And even as we go to the elections, that new framework must be implemented by everybody. Yes. So that progressively this sector can continue to benefit the ultimate stakeholder, who is the Kenyan farmer. Without the farmer, hii chain yote, hii mlolongo yote hakuna. Sindio? Hawa wako hapa katikati sijui nani, mkubwa gani, hakuna. So we must ultimately think about the farmer. So, and we will develop the mechanism to ensure that factories are not taken advantage of, that management services are provided in that manner. Pia, mumeniuliza kuhusu power. One of the biggest cost in the production and manufacture of tea is power. And you have told me three things. Number one, mumenieleza ya kwamba you want a mechanism where there is a willing facility to allow farmers who have hydro facilities to feed into the national tariff and to be able, when they are not using the power, to be paid for that tariff. That one I want to confirm to you that I am going to do it. Because it makes sense. If we are doing it for others, we must do it for our farmers. We are already doing it for the high voltage. We will make sure, and I will give instructions to the ministry to expedite. I know there is already some work going on because they briefed me, so that within 90 days we will come back here and we will sign it off. Number two, you have asked me that you want to participate in this whole campaign around climate change. And because you sometimes use wood fuel in your factories, you want to work with Kenya Forest Service to see whether you can participate in growing of trees in a manner that is mutually beneficial, that we can allocate you spaces in our forested areas, that you can do commercial forestry where you harvest and we share the benefits between your factories and the Kenya Forest Service. So I have already consulted with the Kenya, with the Ministry of Environment, and the Kenya Forest Service have agreed. I will now ask you and your management to sit down with the management of the Kenya Forest Service so that you can sign a framework agreement on how you're going to participate in our tree growing endeavor, but in the process also be able to harvest trees commercially in a manner that is beneficial to you and beneficial to us. So hiyo mpango nimeshaongea na watu wa wizara yetu ya mazingira na idara ya Kenya Forest Service. You can work with them, and again we will come back here, God willing, in 90 days so that we can come and consummate that that process. Pia, so those are the two important areas that you have told me about power. Pia, kuna mambo mungetaka tufanye. Na ni mambo ambayo yatatusaidia katika hii area ya value addition. How do we grow the market? How do we improve earnings of our farmers? Kwanza waje nianze na Iran. Iran, rais wa Iran alikuwa hapa na tuliongea na yeye kwa kirefu. Juzi nimetuma balozi mpya wa Kenya kule Iran. Na nimempatia brief mzuri ya kati ya mambo lazima afanye akiwa Iran. Na nimempatia 90 days. Sasa siku 45 imeisha. Na ngojea another 45 days, alafu nitamuuliza vile mambo yalivyo. Kwa sababu soko ya Iran ni soko ya muhimu. Na tulipata matatizo kwa sababu ya wafanyibiashara walio leta hitilafu. Mali fulani mfanyibiashara mmoja hapa Kenya na mwingine kule walikosana, wakatuletea matatizo. So that market, we will focus on it, and it is my intention to unlock that market because I know the value of that market. Ya pili ni the potential we have in orthodox and other specialized teas. That is a very useful space. That's a very important area. Because, as the leader of majority said here, we need a strategy as a country. We need a strategy on how to package, first even to grow, to manufacture, to package, to sell, to brand our tea so that we get the right value. We are the third largest producer of tea in the world. And yet, there is no Kenyan tea brand. It is unforgivable. You know? We cannot be producers of that magnitude. And nobody knows. There is nowhere. If you go outside Kenya, you will find no market. You will find no supermarket that sells Kenyan tea. So Kenyan tea is sold, you know, in all manner of brands except a Kenyan brand. So we cannot continue this way because we are serving other people's interests. We are not serving our own interests. I mean, how is it the case that we are selling 96% of our tea in bulk, in sacks, you know, with no brand? Gunia tu imewekwa hapo. Inaandika tu black tea. From where, nobody knows. Going where, nobody knows. You know, we must correct that. And we must begin. Nobody should tell us it's too late. Last year, I met the people who sell what is called English breakfast tea. Those people called Liptons. I sat with them last year in Amsterdam. And I asked them, I mean, surely, you know, there is no English tea anywhere in the world. There is no single bush of tea in England. So why are you selling a fallacy? You know? They said, yes, we know that. In fact, of all their tea, and they are the largest tea marketers in the world, 50% of their tea come from Kenya. Right? So I told them, we need to have a conversation. It cannot continue like this. Because ikisonga songa vile inaendelea, nyinyi lazima mutafute chai yenu ndio muuze. Hii yetu, we have to find a name for this tea of ours. Subsequently, they followed me. They came here. We had a meeting with them. Wakaniambia ile maneno ulituambia tumesikia. Sasa tunataka mutueleze, munataka tufanya namna gani. So tumeketi chini na wao. Sasa wamekubali. Walikuja tena last week. Kwa wale mnafuatilia. Walikuwa hapa last week. Sasa wamekubali mambo mawili. Ya kwanza wamekubali, we are going to develop a Kenyan brand together. The same way Sri Lanka have Ceylon tea. And you know, let me give you the story. Ceylon, Sri Lanka, they produce half the tea we produce, right? They produce like 250 million kilos. We produce 500 million kilos. We sell and make 1.4 billion dollars. They make 2.5 or 2.6 billion dollars. They produce half our quantity, yet they sell twice our price. Unaona ile hasara tuko naye? I mean, meaning Let me give you what it means. It means if they are making 2.5 billion for 250 million kilos, if it was 500 million kilos, they would be making how much, Bwana Chairman? $5 billion. Yeah? They'd be making $5 billion. Which means, instead of us making $1.4 billion, we should be making $5 billion. That's what it is. And how does it happen? Get the right brand, get the right packaging, do the right marketing. That's what we must do. You know, the leader of majority was harassing me that I should do it, because he knows I'm already doing it. Yeah, because he knows we are on course. So I told you that we have agreed two things. Number two, we have also agreed to set up an academy in Kenya where we are going to have this conversation about tea. How do we grow the tea? How do we do it properly? So we are well on course. And I'm going to ask that we all hem in and do what we must. Number three, and I want you to listen to me very carefully. Last year, these MPs are here. We changed the law to remove taxes on materials for packaging of tea. We did that in the last year's budget as a first step. Number two, I want to promise you that we must develop common user facilities. I heard the chairman say this. We need to expand common user facilities so that we begin the branding of our tea. We begin the packaging of our tea. We cannot continue to export our tea in sacks. Eh? Na sasa nyinyi mmeketi tu hapa kama wangwana nyinyi machairmen na tunauza chai yetu kwa magunia sasa. Alafu mnataka tuwapige tu makofi throughout. Hapana. No. Eh? And that is why I am a very strong believer in the tea reforms. Yeah, we must reform our tea sector. And we gave ourselves targets. And I want the tea industry to push me. I am ready. We need this. So long as you promise me that in the next 3 maximum to 5 years, we will be exporting our tea 60% value added. Lakini kama tunaendelea na hii 96% tunauza tu chai kwa magunia, haiwezi kuendelea namna hiyo. Ama namna gani ndugu zangu? Si namna hiyo? Yes, you people must also think. Usikue tu ati unaitwa chairman, unapigiwa makofi, na chai inauzwa kwa magunia. I am a very big sympathizer of how we can work with you to expand facilities for orthodox tea. Somebody has said here we made a commitment as government to support companies. If there was that commitment, I want to know so that I can keep that commitment. Bwana Chairman, kama hiyo commitment iko, watu wangu hapa nitamwambia waziri so that we sit down and we structure that support so that we can get our companies to produce specialty teas. And I am ready to put public money to support that industry because of the so many people who become ultimately the beneficiaries of this sector. And I know for sure that if we invest in common user facilities, if we invest in specialty teas, if we do more value addition, we can double our earnings from tea. And that is what we must do. Nini mnanisikia? That is the reason why I wanted to meet you. Ndio muelewe which direction are we going. Sio hii kuongea tu ya kawaida hapa, huyu anashindana huyu, huyu anashindana huyu. Hiyo ni sawa, lakini we must do the right thing. So, common use of facilities, I want to know what the strategy is so that I can support. Orthodox tea, I want to know what the plan is so that I can support. Maneno ya, I already have a plan. I want to just make sure KTDA and tea board are on board on branding, on making a Kenyan tea brand. So that even as we sell, wherever it is we are selling brand Kenya. We better begin now. Let me, in conclusion, say two final things. First, I agree, and I will provide the necessary resources, and then I will ask the Chief Justice to appoint people so that we can have a tea tribunal. A tea tribunal will help us sort out little quarrels, disagreements, misunderstandings, and be able to provide an easy way that does not involve too much litigation, that people can find an easier mechanism of doing that. That again, I want us to come back here in 90 days, so that by 90 days we come and say there is a tribunal. I also want to say that there is money, which your chairman said here, that was invested in Imperial Bank and Chase Bank. I have already given instructions to the head of public service to work with all the stakeholders around that space so that we can pay you that money. I know it is a bit difficult, lakini nitatafuta njia. Sindio? Yeah, lakini kwa sababu hiyo pesa sio ya mtu mmoja. Hiyo pesa ni wakulima wengi. So we will make sure that the right approach is made, including the Attorney General. Again, in 90 days, when we come here, we must have paid that money. Sindio, wanachama? Alafu, nafikiri mambo ni hayo. Ile ya mwisho ni vile tutashirikiana. Kwanza, mimi nataka niwaulize nyinyi kama chairman na hasa KTDA head office. You know, ukisikia watu, umesikia watu wakisema panapofuka moshi hapakosi moto. Your expenditure, you need to look at your expenditure. Mimi niliita heads of parastatals, my chairman na CEOs hapa, nikawaambia we are reducing by 30% all our recurrent expenditure, because you have to live within your means. Sasa ile story tunaambiwa ati chairman ya KTDA travel ana travel first class. Ana huyo mwingine akitravel ana travel first class. Kwani second class iko shida gani? Bwana wasu sana. Huyo anasema au kusema ukweli, lakini so please, nimewaambia panapofuka moshi iko moto. So please, I want to tell you, as a friend of farmers, we must manage unnecessary expenditure. This is not your money. This is farmers' money. You must have it in your mind, always. Yeah? Mambo ya uchaguzi, mimi nimefurahi ya kwamba, unajua uchaguzi, sisi wote tuko hapa kwa sababu ya uchaguzi. So, hakuna siku ya kusongesha, hakuna kutongeza uchaguzi. Yetu ikifika, tunangangana, tunafanya. So yenu ikifika, please, kila mtu aingie kwa mlolongo, tunyoroshane, alafu tuendele. So, Sijui kwa nini watu wanasema ati kuna watu hawataki uchaguzi nini sijui kwa nini wanasema, lakini nimesikia kutoka mwenyekiti, nimesikia kutoka ndugu yangu kutoka Butere, nimesikia kutoka wengine, hata Kagombe amesema mko tayari kwa uchaguzi. Then there is no problem. Yeah, so tuendeni kwa uchaguzi kwa sababu nafasi ambazo tuko nazo ni ya wananchi. Na wananchi wakulima ndio watasema. Sindio? So I think there shouldn't be any quarrel. I think the way it was agreed by all the stakeholders, let us have elections, let the farmers make a choice. Na mimi pia nataka niwaulize wakulima. Wachague watu wenye wako na uwezo ya kusimamia mali yao. People with integrity. People who understand the farmer issues. And people who cannot be compromised. You know? Kwa sababu, wakulima pia lazima wawe waangalifu. Wachague watu wenye wako na msimamo sawasawa, watu ambao wana... sio watu ambao mambo yao inaenda kombo kombo, straightforward people who can take care of their interests. So tufanye kazi hivyo, na vile vile tutaona pia tuondoe ugomvi kati ya KTDA na T-Board. We want to find a place where we can all work together for the farmers. Unajua board ya KTDA ndio arm ya serikali ya kusaidia kufanya regulation ya hiyo sector. Ya T-Board, sorry. Ya T-Board ndio inanisaidia kufanya regulation ya hiyo sector. Na kama kuna matatizo, mnatueleza so that turekebishe. Mwisho kabisa, sijui ni mzee Kirundi ama nani alisema ati mumeambiwa ati serikali iko na candidates. Please, sikieni, na musikie kutoka kwangu. Serikali ya Kenya does not have any candidates for any position in any place in KTDA. Sawa sawa. Candidates ni wananchi wenyewe, wale wakulima wenyewe, ndio watapanga mambo hiyo ya candidates. Ndio, na kila mtu aende ajitetee kwa wakulima. Mimi mambo yangu ikifika, mimi naenda kujitetea kwa raia. So kila mtu, hakuna shortcut ati fulani anajulikana na fulani, sijui nani. Yule anajulikana na mwenzake amuite kwa harusi ya watoto wake. Lakini sawa sawa. So nimesikia pia chairman ananikumbusha mambo ya forensic audit ile ilifanywa. Kama kuna watu wafisadi ama watu wakora ambao wamechukua mali ya wananchi, mimi hakuna mtu will be protected by anybody. Mambo ya kulimana na ufisadi, hiyo niko ni mstari ya mbele. Tayari nilitangaza Kenya, wezi, wakora, wafisadi, mambo yao ni so hawa watu yote watafunga hiyo safari, kwa sababu we do not want to entertain people who harvest from where they have not planted anything. Watu ambao wanatusumbua, wanatuletea hasara. So tuko pamoja na nyinyi hapo, tushirikiane. Mimi nawatakia heri, na nimesema haya mambo yote nimeandika hapa na officer wangu hapo. I hope you have recorded all the issues. I will want us to come back here in 90 days. Ndio tukuje tuweke tick 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 tick, ile bado iko kasoro tunyoroshe, ndio hii sekta isonge mbele. Si namna hiyo? Kwa sababu saa zingine tunaongea alafu mambo inaishia hapo, tunaenda. I don't want us to do that. We must meticulously implement every commitment that we have made. So in 90 days, najua uchaguzi itakuwa imemalizika. Wale mta faulu tukutane. Wale mta faulu tutakutana. Wale hamta faulu, mambo itaendelea tu, Kenya itasonga mbele, hakuna problem. Lakini mimi nawatakia heri nyinyi wote. So otherwise, asanteni sana, mimi nimefurahi sana. This is one of the most important meetings that I value, because we are discussing about the economy of the Republic of Kenya and the economy of 650,000 households in Kenya. So nataka niseme asante sana, na watakia heri, mukirudi nyumbani, salimieni factory zenu, wale directors wengine, wakulima wote, na waambie mambo yao, tumepanga mambo yao mzuri.